Okay, today I'm gonna speak with you about job satisfaction, and not just job satisfaction like for usual common people. We are all immigrants, because, and I prepared this presentation for especially for immigrants. Job satisfaction in a context of immigrants. And I want to ask you, how many jobs did you have in your life? Approximately?
Three, four, five.
Oh, you're strange. Just one job. Okay, but it depends of age. Statistically, the Statistics Bureau of Labor said that average 11 jobs has have each person before he reached 40 years, 40, 50. It could be more. Well, and my second question is, did you like your jobs or one of your jobs?
Yes.
You like it?
Yeah.
You don't like it? No one jobs? No. Any jobs you don't like? You didn't like. Okay, yeah. Statistically, about 90% is different years, but 80-90% are satisfied with your job. But what does it mean, satisfaction? What you like in your job? Why do you go to this job you like and do it? Why?
Because of salary.
Because salary, money. Yes. Something else? Yeah, because really, the first thing is money. Yeah, the biggest thing is money. But if you get already money, you don't need to work for money. What? Why you will work, or you don't want to work?
If you
have money, yeah. It's, there are some other things of motivation and you see satisfaction, and it means good job is doesn't mean perfect job. And what? Would you say what is a perfect job for you? Good if you go there not for money, but
for friends.
What?
To meet some people. Some people.
Yeah, it can be different reason. But did you have a perfect job in your life?
Yes.
No.
Yeah, well,
this is what
the first person. Yeah, and we are here, maybe...
I have a job that I enjoyed a lot.
You enjoyed...
Wasn't the perfect, but...
But you enjoyed.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, we are here 12 or 15 people, and two people had such a job. It's about how many percent? 10? 15? Okay. actually, it's about job that you go work for money. If you go work for money, you work for money, and your life go on, and you didn't enjoy it. Don't enjoy it. The perfect job is like you said. If you go to the job and you not on the job, you make your hobby. You like it. You live here, and you don't work. You enjoy it. And statistically, we said just 10-15% are satisfied with not satisfied, have a perfect job, and what we see in this statistic chart that in most people in 20 years want to change their job and then actually it's degrees, but still, and at 40 age, people want to change something in life and do some different job. And what was my next question? I haven't any question. like immigrants, we have some issues in comparing to Native American, because we came here, we have we need to learn language, we need something know local rules and make some more things than usually to American, to get not perfect job, just good job, job for money. And this is a problem. What we should do here, like immigrants, what how can we choose the right way for us? And I have three possibilities, three solutions I found, and I will present you. First solution is unskilled job. You came, you can't speak, and you can just do something physical, like cleaning, or for example, I was driving a taxi first 2 months, and maybe I will do it the next couple months. But this solution is not good, because if we came here, we want to improve ourselves. We came here for better life, for better salary, for improve our life. And this solution could be, but not for us, because if we are here, we are already very ambitious, and we want something more than just do this unskilled job. And it could be like surviving job, it's called surviving job, but we want some more rich, high level in our life. And the second solution in this case, get the previous job, the previous profession, but to get it, we should match local standards, we should let evaluate our diplomas, and maybe do some other stuff like additional educations or some certifications. It takes a lot of work. This process very long, maybe half year, 1 year, I don't know. It's especially with professional job. If you was a car driver, you can do this driver license, and in 1 month you will proceed it. But if you are a jurist, a lawyer, or I don't know, what is your profession?
I was working for a notary.
Sorry?
For a notary, I was clerk.
Clerk. Yeah, you was clerk, and it was a different role in your country, and here you should learn it from the beginning. Yeah? And someone else, what was the profession?
Yeah, young.
The young. Who is not young?
I was a student.
Yeah, he was a student. It's probably not completely much you, but maybe your parents. Are your parents here, or?
No, my parents, he's working the same as well. Same thing. Not so square.
But they satisfied? Are they satisfied with the job? Do you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. The reason you should do a lot of things to get back in your profession, and when if you don't like it, it's very strange. Then you come back and do what you don't really like. And I have a third solution. I maybe for someone who don't like the previous job is the best solution. It's a career change. Career change, and you will do something else, not what you did in your previous lives. It's for people like 30, 40, maybe 50, it's, I speak to you, it's very hard decision, because it's a lot of cons against it. But we can see examples of this changing everything around every around us in our daily life, and we have some examples, very famous examples. There are many examples, but for example, you know who is it?
Yeah.
Young people, I ask you, who is it?
But they are young.
They are young.
Okay, he's I guess 30 president, 30s, 60s president.
No, he was president in the 80s. From 1981, he was sworn in.
No, I mean the number of presidents.
Let's see, he was number 30. Let's see.
30, 40,
39, maybe 37.
Yeah, around 40s. 40s president of United States.
He was
it's Reagan, Ronald Reagan. And he was the first actor, famous actor, and then he became a president of the United States. And the same thing with actors is this man, this when Terminator goes to Hibernator. It's in the year of 56. He was 56 and he became Hibernator and was Terminator. And the newest example is this man, the richest man in the world. It's Amazon owner. I forgot how is his name. I check it, Bezos, but it's a family name. So someone knows what is the name of this person? No? Bezos. Okay, Bezos. We say it. Bezos. He worked on Wall Street. He was a great financial manager, very successful. But then he switched to your job and started to sell books first and became an internet entrepreneur that the richest man in the world he is now. And obviously there is some pros and cons for this decision, and I want to start from cons, from negative things. It's like if you won't change your life, your everything what you had before, it's very uncomfortable. You should do these annoying things. You don't know how to do it, but I would say we are all came here like immigrants, and we have already a lot of things that uncomfortable. We feel us here not very comfortable because language, because these issues with job, everything. And one little addition, it's not comfortable. Okay, I can do it. I proceed. You can give me a less point, but it's interesting. Okay. Second, you will get less money, but for immigrants, it's not a reason, because even if we are professional, we at the beginning we don't get so big money than other American, for example. At the beginning we get less salaries than others, and it's not the reason. And it could be that you go to the new workplace, and you are like me, for example, 40 with tail. Can I say 40 with tail? 40
plus.
40 plus. Okay. 40 plus, and some young guy, maybe 20 years old, will your boss. It's not, it's not very comfortable. But in other case, if you are professional and you have 20 years experience, and you did a lot of thing, and the same young boss want to say how to do it. It's more uncomfortable than if you are novice in this profession. And the main question in this case, like difficult decision, it's right or not? You will ask yourself, Stanley, if I did the right decision or it's not right. Maybe I should stay in my previous profession. But I have a lot of positive things in changing of career. First, it's your own decision. Nobody tell you to go this way. Parents, friends, you don't go there because it's very modern, very trend. It's not the trend. And you make your own decision and you take responsibility for this decision, and you can't say it, she said me do it.
What?
What? This was an example. You...
Oh, okay. You are so scary. I didn't do that.
Okay, and go ahead. If you like this profession, you will learn quickly, way more quickly than other people who just sit here and get bored. You like it and you learn, and from this second pros flows the third reason. You get professional in this way more quickly than others, and at the end you will get more money for your job because you are professional, and if you are professional you can do this job excellent, and the community and society will get benefits from your job because you will like to do it for everybody, for you can do a great job and you can show it for everyone. And what you said, you meet new people and you get new knowledge, your brain works very hard, and you feel yourself, you feel very strength, I don't know, like Superman. Woo! And you at the end you get your life back and you will enjoy your life and like walk like to be here, you will like be in your workplace. Today I told you about a problem, especially for immigrants, problem about job satisfaction and how to get a job that you will like the whole life. And we spoke about what is good job and what is bad job, and we see some statistic from in American statistic from American people, but it meets, I think, whole world. Not maybe some poor countries, but yeah, almost whole world. And I offered you three solutions, and maybe the second or third solutions for each person. You can pick your solution that you satisfy. For me, is solution three. I want to try to change my career path, but maybe for who won't stay in profession, he could pick the second solution. And for these people, I can add some useful information. I have experience with it. It's this organization, Upwardly Global. Here's the address. What they did, what they do. They provide you services to get your professional job again in the US. They give you, their services are free. It's a free organization. You can donate them, but they get some grants, and they do this job for free. You get some mentor or tutor, I don't know the personality. This person will help you improve your resume, will help to customize your cover letter and resume for a special position. They provide some trainings like mock interview. It's called mock interview. You go somewhere. For example, I was in a big organization, Accenture. It's a consulting organization, and I tried to speak in the surrounding like in a real interview. It was not a real interview, but real people, real HR specialist, and I spoke with him, and then I got feedback about my interview, and I could improve or answer on questions. And the best thing they do is if you need some additional education in your profession, additional certification or something else, it costs a lot of money, but they pay it. For example, I need a PHP exam. It's a project PMP, project management professional exam to do here. It cost about $2,000, and they paid for me, and I do it for free.
But what?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Why
yeah.
did they pay?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I said. And also, what about English? There is some. Good application for phones, phone that help improve your English. It costs also maybe 100 or I don't know how it costs, but they give you a code and you can use it for free. I use it. It's a lot of assignment that you can just hear and answer, and this is a reason I use it when I drive my daughter to school. I use this application. I drive 20 minutes there and 20 minutes back, and this time I learn English too, and it's very very comfortable. Not sometime you should type something, but park please and type, not while driving. Okay, that's it. Well, thank you for listening, and I hope you have questions.
I know you're doing and you got new diploma. Is that what you say?
It's not diploma, it's certification, like certification. I will do this for certification.
So I would like to know what you were doing before and what you want to do after.
Well, my field was construction and especially project management and construction. I worked as project manager, and then I like CEO of a construction company, and then I started my own company, and I run it 7 years before I came here. And I have 20-25 years experience in construction, but I don't want to do it more. I don't know. I came here and I have maybe 6 months I'm here, and I understood that I want to do something else. It's bored me, this construction, the 25 years. I will work maybe till 60, 70 years, and I became a professional in 20 years, I will become in next 20 years professional too. And my next career, I hope it's IT. Technology, information technology. I try now to study some program languages, and I like it. You just sitting at the monitor and type, and you don't need go somewhere and speak with this people. I mean, mostly people I don't like in this profession. It's how to say, the governments. They give permissions because they have rules, and you should follow the rules. But I don't like follow the rules. And if I make programming, I have a variety of ways. There is some rules, but I can change it if I want. If I don't want, okay, I follow rules. If not, but if you go to the government people, they say, okay, just this way and nothing else.
You didn't tell us about the time you need to change your life, your career, to get another professional role in the society.
Yeah.
So does it take time to do that?
It's yeah, like, sure. You
yeah.
should.
So you need more than one life.
No. How long should you study to get a lawyer here?
Here, I don't know.
Here.
In my country,
six years. Yeah, we speak
here.
But in your country, you are already a lawyer. You came here, you want to be a lawyer, but you should maybe let evaluate your diploma.
Yes.
And then they say you should learn more, maybe 2-3 semesters. Yeah, it's 1.5 years, and then you should make certifications for lawyer. It's 1 year more. You have already 3 years to study here, and before you should study English 2 years. Yeah, you have again 5 years to get back your profession.
Yes.
But in 5 years, I will be great programmer, great developer, IT developer. 5 years, 5 years. It's a lot of time.
Yeah,
I have a question. As you said, you have three solutions, but the second one and the third one, is there any different? I think it's very similar. The second one is reskilling. The third one is a new career.
Reskilling, maybe it's not correct word. I just saw in the dictionary. Maybe you can...
It's very similar, you know?
It's not re-education, it's re-skilling, like get these certifications and additional information about market or about rules. For example, I am like a construction person.
So,
I have
like
here...
Transferring your skills? Transferring?
It's still in your professional area.
Still in your profession.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
okay,
just transferring
okay.
your skill.
It's not a new skill.
I had a lot of rules for building in my country, and I came here completely different rules,
okay.
And I should learn it new, and it takes a lot of time.
I got the picture. Another question is, could you give me this website? I try to search and...
It's like upward the global point dot org and
.org.
Upwardly global. Upwardly, it's like it means go up.
I try to search the additional.
Yeah, upwardly global. This is the same. It's the same transcription.
Okay.
Just point work and if you want,
yeah,
I can give
try.
You. You can do
yeah,
it right
no,
now.
No, it's enough. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, something else. No question. You had a question, no?
Yeah.
Please,
seat. We have 20 questions for you.
But we've got three.